Hey guys, welcome to Let's Play Bioshock with me, Cass. This is the first video in the series. This is for my first series. Learn how to English, Cass. Yeah. I'm doing this because it sounded like fun and I wanted to mess around with my computer some more. So, let us begin. New game. Hard difficulty. Now the eggs are in the scramble. Ryan will be
They told me. Son, you're special. You were born to do great things. You know what? They were right.
And here we are. So, a few things before the initial start. I really wanted this Let's Play to be more oriented towards the game. I want that to be the main part of it, you know, obviously, but you'll hear me doing commentary, but I will shut up at times and let you listen to things, so. There's the beautiful lighthouse. Yeah. And I actually read the book Bioshock Rapture, which is the prequel to the first and second games. Just the second, viewers. Sorry, viewers. I had to deal with my dogs. That was actually a good first take. We're like 3 minutes in. Anyways, what was I saying? The book, yeah. It's a prequel to Bioshock 1 and 2. So I can, you know, give you information on that. It's all about the start of Rapture and how it fell. All that fun stuff. No gods or kings, only man. Hey, that song sounds familiar. In what country is there a place for people like me, Andrew Ryan? Compensating for something? Science, industry, art. Yeah, so let's head on into the bathysphere. Fathoms. 8. 15 fathoms. Fire at your fingertips. Incinerate by plasmids by Ryan Industries.
I am Andrew Ryan, and I'm here to ask you a question. Is a man not entitled to the sweat of his brow? No, says the man in Washington, it belongs to the poor. No, says the man in the Vatican, it belongs to God. No, says the man in Moscow, it belongs to everyone. I rejected those answers. Instead, I chose something different. I chose the impossible. I chose Rapture. A city where the artist would not fear the censor, where the scientist would not be bound by petty morality, where the great would not be constrained by the small. And with the sweat of your brow, Rapture can become your city as well.
This game. This is my favorite game of all time. That intro. A few things. If you played Bioshock Infinite,
we're gonna need to draw out of hiding, but you're gonna have to trust me.
I do, Atlas. Great chain is guided by our hand. Anyways, if you played Bioshock Infinite or seen someone play it, at the beginning, when you're gonna take the baptism, the priest or whatever says, "Is it someone new?" Just like she did there. Ooh, references. And also, not until recently after I read the book.
I'll wrap you in a sheet.
And seeing that, did I think of the splicers as like people? I always thought of them more like zombies. But they aren't, they're just drugged up people.
Ah!
hooked on Adam.
Now, would you kindly find a crowbar or something? Bloody splicer, seal Johnny in before they... Goddamn splicers.
I freaking love his accent, by the way. It's always nice to listen to Atlas. Would you kindly... Kindly not throw a couch at me?
I
Good
didn't
God.
Touch her!
Come here. No, they're crazy, but they do have conscious thought. Like, he was trying to talk her into not killing him, which obviously didn't work out too well, but, yeah. Gatherer's Garden. Yeah, no gods or kings, only a man. I have a shirt that says that. Rapture shirt. I got it at Comic-Con. Great chain of industry. Ties and unites us. Curious. Gimme.
Steady now. Your genetic code is being rewritten. Just hold on and everything will be fine.
This little fish looks like he just had his cherry popped. Wonder if he's still got some Adam on him. Yeah. Let's bug. Weak! You're a weak chopper.
This little fish ain't worth telling it with no Big Daddy.
Yellow! Always have been! You'll be no better off with Metal Daddy, little fish. See you floating from my...
Mr. Bubbles, it's an angel! I can see light coming from his belly. Wait a minute, he's still breathing. It's all right. I know he'll be an angel soon.
Yeah. I guess I started doing this. I mean, haven't we all wanted to do this? I watch Let's Plays all the stinking time. So that, why don't I try one? Sounds fun. Also, it's a good learning experience. I'm gonna be going to college this fall for... game design. Yes. I'm really freaking excited about that. Come on, Jack. You can do it. There we go. Yeah, I'm just excited because I read the book.
Splicer! Give him the combo! Zap him, then whack him! 1-2 punch!
I'm not a
Remember,
bad person!
The 1-2 punch!
Oh, no!
It's supposed to go like. Zap him and whack him, then they're dead. But that guy hasn't been cooperative the past few times we played this. But the book is so descriptive, and it's... Oh, my gosh. And I'm just excited to play through it again and see all these places that I now know. Hey there, ow. Just a second, viewers. I'm sorry about that. Still getting the hang of my... I'm using Bandicam. And for some reason, when I somehow go out of the region and click...
Tell Ryan, I'm sorry.
Like,
no, I won't do it again. No, please,
pauses
please,
the game.
Don't.
Jesus.
Leave me alone! Come on!
Uh-huh. Anyways, places that I know, and I can connect the story a little bit more. That's what I hope to do with you guys. Story was hard to get the first time I played this.
Listen, I've got a family. I need to get them out of here. But the splicers have cut me off from them. If you can reach them in Neptune's bounty, then maybe, just maybe... I know you must feel like the unluckiest man in the world right now, but you're the only hope I'll ever see my wife and child again. Go to Neptune's bounty. Find my family, please.
You're gonna be the lonely one when you are the lonely one.
Yeah, I hope to
sing this
help you understand the story.
Hush.
Nice.
Plasmids changed everything. They destroyed our bodies, our minds. We couldn't handle it. Best friends butchering one another. Babies strangled in cribs. The whole city went to hell.
The great chain is guided by our hand. That was Ryan's whole thing. We're all a part of the Great Chain. He wanted to build this utopia, which, come on, those never ever work. This is familiar. There's a big New Year's party here.
And it... I'm not some kind of sap.
I'll do what I want. It's my Adam. I earned it.
And it didn't go too well, as you can see. Some big main characters there. Probably the only good person in this entire godforsaken place was Bill McDonough.
I just spiced up. Nobody's gonna want me.
Brenda!
He was there. You can hear some of his audio diaries.
Care to tell me why you had a hole in the wall the size of Plymouth Rock coming out of your crapper going on 3 weeks now? Nah, I ain't saying I'm Shakespeare. I'm trying to run a respectable theater. I got work in the coming in from Fort Neptune trying to catch a little bird. All I can think about is the stink coming out of your shitter. Get it fixed.
And would I be sure that this is long beyond...
Charlie, where are you going? No.
Oh. He was my favorite character in the book.
Another New Year's, another night alone. I'm out and you're stuck in Hephaestus, working. Imagine my surprise. I guess I'll have another drink. Here's a toast to Diane McClintock. Silliest girl in Rapture. Silly enough to fall in love with Andrew Ryan. Silly.
Yeah, there was a big attack. And since this isn't a blind... Oh, what in the world just happened? Since this isn't a blind Let's Play,
stop!
I'm going to try my absolute best to not give away anything. But... yeah. I'll just tell you things when we get to them.
You spot a splicer in the water. Hit him with the electrobolt.
I love that. Alright, let's head upstairs.
That's mine, hang up!
Hey there. Sorry. I never understood the function or the point of this in all the games. No idea why they did that.
Careful now. Would you kindly lower that weapon for a minute?
Yeah.
You think that's a child down there? Don't be fooled. She's a little sister now. Somebody went and turned a sweet baby girl into a monster. Whatever you thought about right and wrong on the surface, well, that don't count for much down in Rapture. Those little sisters, they carry Adam, the genetic material that keeps the wheels of Rapture turning. Everybody wants it, everybody needs it.
And it explains, the book explains exactly how the little sisters came to be. And the big daddies, which still scare the crap out of me. In a good way. Like scary movies. You're in trouble, dude. Why shows the Unbound thing.
The fight is over now. The dawn is drawing very nigh. Let's creep away from
the... Come on, they're scary. The first time I played this, I was convinced that if you got near them, they would attack you. Like, if they saw you. Like, these guys. Not till I was like 3/4 of the way through the game. Did I realize that they could give a care if you walk in front of them? As long as you don't engage the little sisters, then there's no real problem with you. Which led me to take 10 times longer on the game, because I spent so much time hiding from them.
I can control myself! I can! Come on! Damn it!
You gotta be rich down here to meet a lady. They don't care how nice you are.
I know, thank you very much. Gimme. Altruism. altruism is the root of all wickedness. And Orion. Quite the character. See, what the hell is the point of that? No idea. Oh, God. It's not weird. I'm looking. Sometimes there's stuff. He shines shoes.
Security alert in pop.
Oh, balls. Didn't mean to do that.
Don't fucking judge me!
There you are.
You killed my Charlie!
Don't run away from me!
How do I keep missing? Stop moving!
You killed my Charlie! You killed my Charlie!
Oh, I need... Eve, die! Goodness me! What was that? Oh!
I just wanted to
no! It's the opportunity. Dang it! Oh, dang it! First death. 27 minutes. Thank you. Seems like a good time to end the episode. Alright, guys. Thanks. Thanks so much for watching, and I will see you in part 2.